please state your name for the folks at home?
Pam.
What? What?
Pam.
Pam?
Pam. I'm Swedish.
Oh, you're Swedish?
Yeah, of course.
Oh, well, that would explain it then. Yeah. I enjoy your healthy spray products when I'm frying. Now, Pam, if I may call you that, what do you do for a living?
A nurse.
A nurse?
Yes.
So you're used to dealing with injuries?
Oh, yeah.
Right, okay. Well, here's a problem. Here's what happened today. This is a real thing. It really happened. I walked into Michael's office over there, right? Yeah. I walked into his office, and I banged my knee on the way in. It was really sore. Oh, and I went, ah, oh, like that. And you know what his first reaction was? I will now demonstrate it to you. And I was like, that would make him a psychopath, wouldn't it?
Halfway.
Halfway? He's a medical professional. So, I think you need some psychopath music. Anyway, look, that's enough. Freaking me out. So, can I show you my knee?
Yeah.
Do I have to pay you, or do you have healthcare in Sweden?
Yeah, we have
it. All right, then. So, have a look at this.
Free healthcare.
Does that look injured to you in any way?
Ooh, that looks bruised.
Wait a minute.
You're right over there.
No, that I go that
way.
Red
Sox, yeah.
Wait a minute. Wait.
Contagious.
Are you really a nurse?
Yeah.
What kind of
a cardiac nurse?
Cardiac
yeah.
nurse. You work only with the heart?
Yep.
A nurse of the heart? You know, there's people that need Pam more than me. Thanks, Pam, but I don't want to waste your time while
you
go... Hey, no, shut up. It's an American slang thing, yeah. we hope you enjoy your time here in America. You don't have to do any... are you working on anyone's heart here?
No. Holidays. Las Vegas next.
Oh.
Yep.
Well, I hope you meet the prince of your dreams.
You know, I meet him, I beat him.
What? What?
You know, I meet him, I beat him.
No,
you didn't
get any.
You know, I meet a princess, or I be like a prince.
Oh, right? Yes, yes. You got a free dinner? Where are we going to send them? We're going to send you to Wolfgang Puck's restaurant here on him. He's going to pay for it. Pam, everybody, we'll be right back.
It's hard to stay up, it's been a long, long day, and you've got the Sandman at the door. But hang on.
Show with Craig Ferguson, sponsored by Progressive. Visit progressive.com today. Ladies and gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
I like that little extra bit at the end there. It made me feel like a matinee idol. Perhaps not. That was a pity one clap or someone... or someone naked sitting down in a leather seat. It's a great day for America, everybody. Yes, indeed, it is. It is a great day. It is a great day for the Republicans. At their convention tonight, the surprise speaker was Clint Eastwood. I know! Clint Eastwood, he was like, yeah. Now, that was a big surprise. I mean, what could be more surprising than a grumpy old white man at the Republican convention? Very sad news today as well. MTV announced the upcoming season of Jersey Shore will be the last. The cast... Very unconvincing. The cast, though, was very emotional, crying, drowning their sorrow with binge drinking. Then they heard they were cancelled. See what I did? You see what I did? I did a... That's a joke right there. I did a thing, and then I did a thing at the end!
Comedy gold, boss.
Comedy gold. Thanks, Jeff. It's a great day for a lot of celebrities. Forbes magazine released the highest paid celebrities list today. The entire list can be found online. What you do is you just Google famous moneymakers, and then you scroll past all the pictures of Prince Harry's junk, and then you'll get to them. You know, whenever I see these naked pictures of Prince Harry, which is about 15 times a day, I think of that old sea shanty I used to sing a lot of the times. He's a... Ginger down below me, boys, ginger down below. Do you know, anyway, the Forbes list. On the Forbes list, for the seventh straight year, Oprah Winfrey is number one. Her earnings last year were $43.2 gazillion. That's a lot of money. Even Mitt Romney's like, damn, O-Dubs is a straight baller. She got more floss than the Fed, y'all. That's how Romney talks. People don't know that about him. It's one of the most interesting things. He's like, damn, old dogs.
That's a great impression.
Thank you. Oprah's number one. She's a very good person, Oprah. She's very rich, but she's very good. She's such a good person. She does good in the world. Do you know that every time Oprah passes gas, global warming goes away a little bit? It's pure oxygen. She also gives a lot of money to charity, and people often say to me, Craig, if you were as rich as Oprah, would you do the same thing? And I'm like, yes, I would give Oprah's money away. I'd keep mine, but I'd give hers away. Now, it won't surprise you, I was not on the list. I am not highly paid or apparently not a celebrity. Perhaps these things are related. Last year, the number one on the Forbes list, well, it wasn't for being rich, but I was number one on the well, did you have the thing from Forbes? There you are, yeah, world. Yes, apparently I'm hairy now. You see that, guys? You know that Dr. Phil is on this Forbes list? I am very surprised by this. I thought Dr. Phil's only source of income was the change that he finds in Oprah's couch. If the heart's short on change, you can't fill up the piggy bank of self-esteem.
Well, that's pretty good.
Yeah, I thought it was pretty good.
That's pretty good.
It's not as good as my Romney, but no, it's got something.
Do your Romney again.
Damn, old Dubs. You see Ryan? Uh-huh.
It's as if Romney is standing right in front of
him. Exactly. It's like he's in the room.
Uncanny.
The Forbes magazine thing. Yeah, now this is supposed to be a serious financial magazine, Forbes, right? But they don't have access to the celebrities' financial information. So, in other words, they made it up. You made it up, Forbes. Shut up. Anyway, how do you define celebrity? That's such a ridiculous... You can't quantify the... I mean, money, yes, but you can't say this is more celebrity than that. Look, like, Snooki is a celebrity. Maya Angelou is a celebrity. They're not... I mean, Maya Angelou and Snooki are very different. One is a respected author whose lyricism captured the angst of a generation, and the other one's Maya Angelou. They're very different. Anyway, right now in Hollywood, self-centered jerks are flipping through Forbes, seeing who's on the list so they know who to suck up to. And that is pathetic. I do not choose my friends based on their wealth. I choose them based on their breasts. Women too. Forbes magazine, of course, run by the billionaire Steve Forbes, who names a magazine after himself. Who would do that? Who would do that?
Oprah.
Yeah.
Yeah, Oprah did it, and Steve Juggs. Anyone else?
Bob Newsweek.
Bob Newsweek, yeah, that's right. Sean Cat Fancy.
Craig High Times.
You know, Steve Forbes, is that his name? I can forget now already, I forgot. Is it Steve Forbes or John Forbes? It's Steve Forbes. Look, it's Forbes anyway. He once ran for president. He lasted about a week and got... So who better to judge other people's success? This is ridiculous. It's like Donald Trump judging a beauty pageant. Which he does.
Oh, yeah.
He does. Do you like him?
I just moved my mouth for no reason.
I'm getting to that age as well. You know, sometimes, like, when I stop at a traffic light, I go like this. Then I look over and I see an attractive young lady and I'm like that. Hey. Yeah, like that.
Yeah, that's the one.
What am I talking about? Oh, yeah, the list. See, these lists, they're pointless. They're just cheap gimmicks to sell magazines. I hate these dumb lists. You know, 10 ways to drive your woman crazy in bed. It's ridiculous. There's only one way to drive a woman crazy in bed. Dutch oven. They hate it.
I love it.
This is the first...
Just open my mouth again.
Oh, you opened your mouth again?
I'm having an issue over here, too.
Yeah, oh, is your mouth moving randomly? You're not trying to open it? It's just
I'm
opening?
Having a few problems.
I would hate if that ever happened to me.
Yeah, it's very strange. Yeah,
is that? Is it really? You don't want it to happen?
It's fine happening? Now. It's okay. Oh, I want it to happen.
You want to do the thing?
Sure, why not?
All right.
Tonight's program is brought to you by Craig Hordes Dairyman Magazine and Jeff Popular Mechanics.
Everyone, my knee is fine. Pam sprayed something on it during the commercial break. And not only does it feel good, it smells delicious.
Love that, Pam.
I love... Do you eat a lot of fried food?
How dare you?
How dare you, sir? It's only a joke. I know you don't have a digestive tract and you live by electricity alone.
Don't have a penis or a heart either.
If you had to choose between one or the other, which would you choose, penis or heart?
Oh, I'm going with the penis.
Yeah. Not the first time you said that, is it, Jeff? Damn horse is staring at me again. You see the horse?
Very creepy.
Yeah. All right, you know what time it is, Jeffrey?
Certainly do.
Well, tell the folks.
It's tweet mail time. Time to take advice from a man who smells of Pam and farty baby.
I don't get the farty baby bit.
That's true. You mentioned you had a farty baby.
I didn't say I had a farty
you
baby.
You did say that once.
Did I say I had a farty baby?
I heard it, yeah.
No, you're high. I never said that.
No.
When did I say I had a farty baby? I have two children. One of them is a baby, the baby size.
Yeah.
He's no fartier than any other baby.
You've mentioned a gas issue. You said there was some sort of gas thing going on.
No. I didn't say that. You're making it up. You're planting evidence.
Or am I?
I thought a shark came in for a minute. All right, do you want to play let's just do our own jingle. You ready?
Yeah, I'd love it.
All right, then.
Yeah.
Tweets and emails. Email time. Oh, yeah. Here come the players, Craig and Jeff, with the emails. emails and tweets. Yeah. This is from Gary in Wheeling in West Virginia. You ever been to there?
Oh, yeah. You like Wheeling? Oh, yeah.
Dear Craig and Jeff, all these new lives make Jeff's head look pretty shiny from the back. Has anyone noticed? Yeah, I think a couple of people have.
Anyway,
did your head look shiny?
Yeah, my head's shiny from the back, yeah.
Wasn't that the name of your autobiography?
That was my album, Shiny from the Back.
Shiny from the back, yeah. This is from Mark in Spokane, Washington. You ever been to Spokane?
Oh, yeah.
You like it? It's rainy up there, very damp,
very
wet.
Nice.
It's lovely, the place, though. Great,
nice.
Great times.
Very
yeah, I look forward to that.
Yeah, great.
Hi there, Craig. Did you actually buy a new suit for Jeff? He looks different. Is that a new suit?
You know, they spared no expense.
This is from Marianne in Columbus, in Georgia. Is it not the one in Ohio? It's the one in Georgia.
Georgia, not Ohio.
No, have you ever been to Columbus, Georgia?
Oh, yeah.
What did you do there?
I did some fishing.
Fishing in Columbus?
Sure, yeah. Get a little pond there.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Anyway, dear Craig and Jeff, is it ever too early to start shopping for Christmas presents? Yeah. Yeah, if you go out like at 6 a.m., the stores aren't open. You can't buy anything.
Yeah, don't be an idiot. Don't overdo it.
Yeah, yeah. Have you bought anything for Christmas?
Oh, hell no.
You don't got my Christmas present yet?
No.
What are you going to get me?
Not going to tell you.
I've got yours already.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Creeping me out, man. What is it?
Pam. Yeah, the actual Swedish nurse, Pam. He's going to come to your house and spray you. This is from Sarah in Los Angeles, California. You ever been to Los Angeles,
oh,
California?
Oh, I think so. Oh, yeah, once or twice.
Naked,
yeah,
a beach, swimming,
swimming
bees,
in the... Yeah, right, yeah.
Dear Craig, Jeff, and Secretariat, who's that at the door? I don't like the creepy horse. I like the dancing horse. The creepy horse creeps me out. I like the dancing horse. Wait. What music is that? It's like the horse is going to start rapping now or something? That would be awesome if the horse could rap.
That looked like some sort of equestrian porn.
Well, in that case, we better see it again. Wait. Now you know why they've got the door halfway like that. Dear Craig, Jeff, and Secretariat, does it get hot in the studio because of the fireplace where Jeff is already hot enough? Oh.
Ooh.
Do you feel the heat coming from the fire there, Jeff?
Thanks for that email, Pam. Yeah, it's very warm, very toasty.
Hey, well, listen, let's go to a commercial break, but let's do it in the form of horse porn.
Okay, yeah.
first guest tonight is a very beautiful actress. She stars in Web Therapy, which is moving to Sunday night, so on Showtime this week. Take a look at this. I, on the other hand, do. Please welcome the lovely Lisa Kudrow, everybody. Lisa Kudrow. Sensational. I like this very elegant black thing.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's lovely.
I like this.
Yes, because the last time you were here, we had an electricity power cut thing.
That's right. There was no electricity.
Yeah, and so that might happen again. There's no guarantees, because this studio is right next door to the... What's happened? What, did you smell something?
No.
You went like this.
I know, because you said it might happen again, and I thought you moved up.
Well, yes, but it's still the same electrical grid.
They're still going to cut your power.
Well, if you don't pay the bill, that's what happens. I thought you'd smelled something nasty.
No.
It smells quite nice here, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Do you know what that smell is?
What? Secretariat?
Pam. It's a nice smell.
Pam's out there, right?
Somewhere. For all of us, there's a Pam out there somewhere. A nurse of the heart. Do you eat a lot of fried food? Clearly not.
I like it.
Really?
Yeah.
What's your favorite thing to eat that's fried?
French fries.
No.
Okay.
Mars bars.
I love Mars bars.
Well, Scottish people eat deep fried Mars bars.
Really?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
I've never heard of that.
Well, I just made it up.
Okay.
No, it's true. There's this thing where they got into, well, the World Health Organization was saying nasty things about Scotland because they were deep frying candy bars and then eating them.
Really?
Yeah. And strangely, people were calling for Pam a great deal. There was a lot of...
But is that a Scottish thing, fried foods? Is it like the South?
Oh, yeah.
Really? Like everyone in Scotland has a deep fryer?
Yes.
Are you serious?
Well, I think...
I don't know.
Yes, there's a lot of deep frying goes on in Scotland and in the South, but a lot of people who are in the South, their families originally came from Scotland. I mean, they didn't bring deep fat fryers with them. Or did they?
No.
No.
Because they didn't have that.
Yeah.
There was no electricity.
Are you still fascinated?
Like your stage.
What? There's electricity here? There's electricity here.
Oh, I know.
Oh, a little bit.
Yeah. Well,
how's the web... You're moving to Sunday nights?
Yeah.
That's good, isn't it?
It's very good.
Right.
Yeah.
Because I never know.
You're doing so well.
Well, yes.
I mean, that's what I say.
Yeah, so David Schwimmer, that's that young man.
That was David Schwimmer.
Yeah, I've heard of him. What's he been doing? I haven't seen him since...
He's directing a lot in plays and stuff, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then he did Web Therapy. He was hilarious.
Yeah.
That clip was a little out of context, I think. But anyway.
What do you mean? It's a clip. Episode. Most clips are out of context. They're in the wrong show.
Right.
I mean, if you showed a show clip of this show on Web Therapy, that would be out of context because...
Well, we'd put it in context.
Well, bully for you.
But you don't have to do that. It's different. You don't have a narrative that you have to stick to.
But there's a bit of a narrative. Yeah. There's Pam, and then I hurt my leg.
Oh, that's right.
And the horse may or may not be a serial killer.
Right.
Or
I like that. It's like a Mr. Ed thing.
Yeah, that's right. Well, we have to have it there.
Someone knows Mr. Ed.
People know Mr. Ed. You don't necessarily have to applaud.
But, I mean, yeah, all right. That's good, because it's before my time. I mean, I'm way too young to have watched Mr. Ed.
Well, I didn't see any of these shows because I was in a different country. All we had was a deep fat fryer.
Deep fat fryer. That's right.
Who have you got on the Web Therapy this season then? Anyone exciting? Apart from David Schwimmer, of course.
David Schwimmer, very exciting. Lily Tomlin.
Mm-hmm. Very. Yes, she's good.
She's great. Mm-hmm. And Victor Garber, of course, is great. And,
yes.
You know, we had, phenomenal people all season. So, you know, if you missed any of them, Craig, you should catch up.
It
was really good. We had Meryl Streep.
Meryl Streep, yes, she's fantastic. I think she might win an Oscar one day.
Well, her fingers.
Did you like the Mamma Mia thing that she did?
Yeah.
I loved that.
Good, yeah.
I loved Mamma Mia. I went to see it when it was in the theater, and I was like, oh, this is great.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was dancing. I cried.
Oh, you did the sing-along?
Yes, you couldn't not do it.
You're so fun. That's fun.
I am. I'm a very fun man. Most people think I'm off stage and miserable. And I am, but...
You're only happy here for this, like, hour and a half.
That's right. I'm a typical late-night talk show host. I only live for this hour when I'm important. The rest of the time, I hate myself. Hey,
Wait, can I say something? But we want you to do web therapy. Oh, now I don't want to put you on the spot here.
No, that's I'll do it. I'd love to do it.
Would you?
Is it actual therapy? Can I tell you my actual real problems?
That would be fantastic.
Right, okay, well, let's start now. I'm only ever happy when I'm doing this show. When I'm not here, I'm miserable and I hate everybody. I actually hate everybody here when I'm doing the show as well, but I fake it for cash. And not very much cash.
Uh-huh. Okay. We kind of did that story with Conan O'Brien.
Every late-night entertainment journalist paused with fingers over the keyboards awaiting my response. Ay, caramba!
That's a good one. But we were thinking maybe you could be somehow related to Alan Cumming is on the show.
Yes, I know Alan. I've known him for years. We did theatre together in Scotland.
You did?
Yes,
what?
Yes. I've known him since I was 20 years old.
Really?
That's almost 10 years. Yes, I know him. Yes. He sort of talks a wee bit more like that.
Right, because he's from...
Right, well, I can talk like that, too.
Oh, that would be great.
I'd be happy to talk like... In fact, this is how I talk when I'm not on television.
That's great.
When I'm unhappy and eating. We have to take a break.
All right.
So,
I'll clam up.
No, you don't have to. Do you wanna introduce the break? Remember your days on television where you had to... Why are you doing that smell face again?
Because remember, what day? How old do you think I am? I never had to introduce the soft soap sponsoring our show. We didn't do live
That's TV. Coming back. You know, I'm going to have to do that soon.
Yeah,
the live commercials thing. They're going to find stuff and I'm going to have
really?
To... Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm going to have to do it here and I'm going to have to pretend I mean it.
You'll be good at it.
I know I will.
All right, how do I...
Because I'll only advertise products that I think are worthy.
You just did the smell face.
Did I?
Yeah, that I think are worthy. You just did, yeah.
No, that's... I'm trying to be sincere. So my sincere face is like your smell face?
You are unhappy.
Do your smell face.
What?
Do your... Well, we'll practice and we'll be right back. I know all about it, but we're back in the air, so I'm not going to tell you any more about it right now. That's how much time we've got? 40 seconds?
Yeah. Uh-oh.
Well, we're out of time, Lisa. How can that happen? How can we talk and then we go to commercial break and come back and there's only 40 seconds? How does that happen?
Too much? What are you saying?
Yeah.
What? Oh, yeah. That's all I want.
He's gone power mad in the new studio. Yeah,
he is. What's his name?
Michael, I think.
Michael.
Yeah. Well, Lisa, we're out of time. What would you like? Awkward pause, mouth organ, big cash prize, or some other delicious shiny apple? You want a shiny apple?
No, I want the coins.
Well, listen, the big cash prize is now less than it used to be. You made the smell face just as I even said that.
the smell face is funny.
Like that. Like,
but what's displeasure then? Is that different from a bad?
Well, I don't know. If for example, you were to smell a Dutch oven, what face would you make?
A Dutch? What is that? Does that mean something else? Is that like a
Dutch oven?
Yeah, I don't know what that
is. Yeah.
What is it?
Well, it's one of those things. It means another thing. It's like, for example, I can't say any of them. We're not allowed.
But what's a Dutch oven?
A Dutch oven is when you're in bed with your friends, or just somebody you know, or perhaps your husband.
Yeah.
And somebody has got a sore tummy, and there's an event that occurs, bottom related.
Oh,
right?
Okay, yeah.
And then they flip the covers over your head so that you can't help but inhale the.
Okay. All right. Really? You couldn't say the word that is? Really?
No, you're not allowed to.
Not allowed?
Well, what word are we thinking?
Is it flatulence? I mean, it's a
flatulence related comic event.
Okay. Yes. Nothing funnier than that. Oh. Well, that's a Dutch oven.
Yeah, right. But okay. What do you call it in Sweden?
In Sweden?
Yeah.
We call it flatulence.
Well, what do you call a Dutch oven then? Or do you not have a name for it? Or maybe you don't
do it
in your fancy Hollywood circles.
I don't know. I don't even know what a Dutch oven is.
Well, I just told you.
No. But is there such
you're
a thing?
You hurt my sore knee right there.
Pam. We need Pam.
All right.
I don't know what a Dutch oven is.
All right. Well, that's the longest 40 seconds in the history of television. All right. Look, there's your money. Get the hell out. Lisa Kudrow, everybody. Extremely funny comedian. His podcast is available on iTunes. I know! Please welcome Marc Maron, everybody. Marc Maron. Hi, Marc. How you doing, buddy?
I'm all right. How are you?
Good. It's good to see you.
Moving up, huh? Got yourself a new bigger space.
Bigger space, a little
money.
More room. Got myself a rhino on the wall.
That's tremendous.
Yeah,
Greg.
It's not a real rhino. It's not a real rhino. No rhinos were killed. It's made of kittens.
No.
Yeah.
Whatever makes you feel good, that's what's important. If you need a rhino up there, that's terrific.
I don't need one. There was just one there when we moved in.
It's already awkward. Do we do the awkward pause now, or do you want
to... You can choose it. If you want to do the awkward pause now, that's good.
I just want to talk to you.
About what?
Whatever you got going. What's happening?
Well, no, that's what it's like when you do your podcast. Mm-hmm. You do that thing, and then I end up saying a lot of things that I regretted.
No, we had a very good episode. What did you regret?
Personal information. I gave you a lot of personal information. I told you my sexual preferences.
I know, and that was awkward when you took that thing out, but I... But you can't see that on radio. No one's going to know you weren't wearing shoes and the wig. I don't want to get into it. We didn't mention that.
We never talked about what kind of sexual picadillos you suffer from. Enjoy?
Well, I think I'm pretty, I don't want to say normal.
You think you're pretty?
I do think I'm pretty. Do you think I'm pretty?
You are quite pretty, I guess. That shirt really makes your eyes pop, I guess.
Oh, stop it. No, I don't know that I have picadillos, but I'm not a I'm fairly regular. I just like, solo meshing, troubling sex. That can lead to crying and a lack of identity. I enjoy that.
And do you care if there's anyone else with you, or
no,
do you prefer to be on your own?
This is something I did in the dressing room by myself. Yeah,
oh,
no, I can do it.
That.
Yeah.
Well, you just rubbed your hang on.
Yeah, what do you got?
Cleaning off my leg. Hey, I have an extra small photograph of Larry King in a frame. Would you like it?
Oh, yes. Thank you very much. I was hoping I would get that.
Yeah.
I'm not, I don't have any fetishes. I don't really understand them. Because...
Did you read the 50 Shades of Grey?
What is that?
That's the
I'm kidding. I don't know what it is. I just did it twice.
Yeah.
I didn't read it. I know it's something that people seem to enjoy.
I think the ladies are enjoying it.
What's it about?
Well, my guess is the clitoris.
Really?
Yeah. It'll be a lot of talk. Now, the clitoris is a thing that... do you know what it is?
Yeah, it's the fun button.
No. The clitoris is like when Harry Potter's in danger, he imagines it, and it fights off his enemies.
Don't we all?
Yeah.
No, I was talking to somebody yesterday about dominatrixes. I was talking,
and I don't. Who were you talking to about dominatrixes?
It came up on the podcast. There was a group of people. I think, I don't want to mention names, but I don't understand that whole thing. Like, I don't know how you, maybe you put on an outfit. You maybe you got, you know, some sort of outfit on. You're yeah. role playing.
Yeah.
It, maybe you're a policeman or a plumber mm-hmm. or an exterminator, which would be weird. Mm. But like, how do you walk into a bedroom about to do something sexual and not go, look at me, look what I'm wearing?
Here's what you do.
I'm wearing a clown's hat.
No. You walk in, for example, if you're yeah. dressed as a cop, you walk yeah. in and go, you're under arrest.
I just got a little tingle.
Yeah, see, right there.
Yeah, yeah. And I'm not even that way, but right. Yeah, did
that set off your Patronus?
Yeah. A little magic you got going
that's
there.
That's right.
Yeah.
Do you know the ones that I'm kind of? I don't want to judge. I mean, people do what they do, but
we can judge. I enjoy judging.
The plushies, the people that like to dress up as
as stuffed animals.
Yeah.
You have one.
Yeah, over there. Yeah. It's,
He's, you know what he's doing yeah. right now? He's rocking. What's going on under the door?
Well, that's what I'm saying. We've yeah. got music for it. Watch. No, no, no. No, not the scary music. The horse porn music. Wait. That's progressive jazz.
You're close to porn music.
No, you can't have porn going that fast. People would complain.
I don't think he's going to complain.
Yeah.
I mean, if that's what he's complaining about, not having to wear the outfit, I think
that's a real thing.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I didn't
knock it
know.
Off, man. Anything you want to say about Santa while you're here, you bastard? Can you believe us, Jeff?
Just crushing dreams.
Yeah, crushing dreams. Crushing dreams. What happened to you, man? You used to be great. Now look at you, crushing dreams.
Hey, isn't that what it's all about?
You're like the opposite of Kevin Costner in that movie.
Yeah, that's who I am now. I'm the buzzkill guy.
Yeah, you're not.
That's not real. He's not real.
He's real.
No, this wood isn't real. I'm starting to question your existence.
Well, you may have a point.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, you're a comedian, right?
Yeah.
Don't do that. Are you desperately sad when you're not performing?
I don't know if desperately sad. I'd say I'm a little anxious, a bit angry. I'm not sad. It's good to get on stage and do some jokes to sort of pretend like people like you. But I don't know if sad is the right word. Sometimes when I'm at home and I'm not doing anything, I'll just be sitting there and I'll say something like, this is ridiculous. And there's no one else around, and then I'll realize, wow, that was pretty pathetic.
Yeah, that's pretty sad.
Because do you ever consider that? Do you ever consider, like, a lot of times you're freaking out about something that is completely in your head? Have you ever had that moment where you're like, oh, it's over. My life is over. Everything's horrible. This is ridiculous.
It's like,
right?
It's like you're in my head right now, man.
Right.
Get out of my head right now.
But then you just realize, like, no, I'm just, there's nothing happening. I'm just sitting
here.
You
just imagine the whole thing.
Yeah, and then from there you go, like, well, I've got to eat a pint of ice cream. And then everything turns around.
Whoa. Hey! I wish we could put that on the air.
What just happened?
Hey, Marc Maron, everybody. We'll be right back. After Mark's appearance in the show, we went to a commercial break, and Mark expressed to me that he thought he wasn't funny. I felt terrible.
Did I say it that way, though? I think you said, how are you? And I'm like, I don't know what just happened.
Yeah. Well, look, you were saying you said I didn't think I was funny. Or then I thought you didn't think I was funny, and I was like, well, that's all right. That's what I do here. But
apparently,
you thought, and I thought, Jeff, we could maybe cheer him up.
Oh, Mark, I assure you, your appearance was a flatulence-related comic event.
Mark, it was like a Dutch oven in television form.
I'm not sure that's a good thing.
It's a great thing, Mark.
So
and here's another thing. You've won the coveted prize, the hardback edition of the Michael Caine biography. Mark Maron, everybody. See you tomorrow. Good night.